To complete the calibration of a triaxial accelerometer, attach the accelerometer to the SCADIS front end through the dynamic input channel using the appropriate cables. Go back to the channel setup worksheet. Ensure that the first three inputs are checked on. Set the channel group ID to vibration. Set the directions appropriately. In the calibration worksheet, change the unit to G, the frequency to 159.2, and the level to 1 RMS. These settings are specific to the calibrator. Click the Advanced button and ensure that the timeout is still turned off. Make sure that the first three input channels are turned on. Change the nominal sensitivity value to 2.5 millivolts per G, which is appropriate for the specific accelerometer being used. Attach the accelerometer itself to the top of the calibrator using beeswax. The direction that is facing up is the direction that will be calibrated. In this case, this is the Z direction. Turn on the calibrator. It is good practice not to attach the accelerometer while the calibrator is running. Select the check button and then the start button. Notice that even though we are calibrating the Z direction, the X direction is also being calibrated. The Z direction has a channel status of OK, and the X direction has a channel status of OK sensitivity different, indicating a possible problem with the calibration on this channel. This message is important. Ideally, while one direction is being calibrated, the channel status of the two other directions should not have a calibration value calculated. If channels other than the intended direction of the accelerometer are being calibrated, crosstalk is occurring between channels within the accelerometer. Crosstalk is when the primary input is one direction and the other directions pick up minute vibrations from the calibration signal. The software sees a calibration signal and causes it to calculate an erroneous calibration on the other direction. To solve this problem, select Break and then go to the Advanced Settings. The SNR parameter might need to be adjusted. SNR is the signal-to-noise ratio. The SNR is a criteria that the software uses to decide if a calibration signal is present on any given channel. The dB difference between the background noise and the calibration tone is evaluated, and the SNR of the signal must be higher than the setting for calibration to occur. By setting the signal-to-noise ratio parameter higher, the off-direction channels will not be calibrated. Change the SNR level to a higher value like 60 dB. By setting the SNR higher, the false calibration trigger caused by crosstalk is eliminated. LMS Test Lab will then calibrate each direction of the triaxial accelerometer separately, one at a time. Let's calibrate again. Press the check button and then the start button. This should calibrate the Z direction only. After the first direction has been calibrated properly and the message area turns to detecting, turn off the calibrator. Rotate the accelerometer so that a different direction is facing up and turn the calibrator back on. Do this until each direction of the accelerometer has been calibrated. Once the message area changes to finished, select Accept and the new sensitivities will be active throughout Test Lab. This concludes the calibration of a triaxial accelerometer and this tutorial.